Once I was a crusader for the Divine Order. I pledged my life to Lucian the Divine. The war changed everything. He sent me to save the elves I grew up amongst. I arrived too late. Lucian ordered the use of death fog against the Black Ring, annihilating everyone I once knew in the process. Now I'm a mercenary killer, one of the infamous lone wolves. And my next target is none other than Lucian's own son.
It all happened like I knew it would. A single drop of source magic. And, like flies to honey, the monsters swarmed. The rabble panicked. The carnage began. And the magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
Still a bit groggy, are we?
Don't worry. The sedative will wear off soon enough. Easy now.
No need to hurry. Get your bearings and report to me upstairs.
Well now, aren't you a curious sight? If I'd had a mask to hide my bones as well as yours, maybe I'd still be walking around today. Where'd you get it? There can't be many curios like that in the world. No. You're here to be collared and shipped like a beast in a cage. Any other pile of bones and they'd suspect, but you... I've never heard such silken tones from a naked skull.
How much do you think I get out? All I know is there are more like you. Well, not quite like, but sorcerers collared on this tub, all heading to Fort Joy. Beyond that, your guess is as good as mine.
Still, you'd best keep that mask on. The living don't take kindly to seeing their future staring back at them.
Junk. Boring. Rubbish. This again. Junk, junk. This again. An animal's sty, freight or food?
Shaking her fluffy coat, the sheep eyes you balefully, her rectangular eyes like letterboxes to the void. With one...
Thank you. under lock and key.
Why, you're looking a bit more chipper. Yes. Looks like that collar fits you snugly enough. There you are. Not too tight, I hope. The collar, I mean. Oh, not to worry. Every dog has to get used to its leash. In the meantime, your next stop will be Magister William. All passengers have to be registered in the ship's manifest, and he's the chap in charge of the logs. You'll find him on the other side of this deck, in the officers' quarters. Why? Because we're at sea, of course, and have been for several days.
Index fingers pressed to her lips. She pauses a moment to give you a scrutinizing gander.
My word, you do seem a bit befuddled, don't you? Perhaps I was a bit too generous with that sedative. Oh, well, I'm sure you'll soon gather your wits. Most likely. Eventually. In the meantime, all you need to know is that we're en route to Fort Joy. A new life awaits, and if you're a particularly good boy, perhaps a cure as well. An end to Source. For good.
Empty.
Junk.
What a well of knowledge this tome is. Dallas is
good
such
gods,
a dear
this,
lending it to me.
There's been a murder here.
What have we here? A fresh face in this stale hell. Let's size you up, shall we? See if you'll do.
The lizard looks you up and down, like a farmer would a fetching horse. All of a sudden, he grips you firmly by the chin, with the intent of inspecting your teeth.
There's some discoloration, as well as a rather disconcerting lack of tongue and gums, but I've seen worse. After all, one can't expect to find prime merchandise on a squalid little ship like this. Now then, to business. You will answer me three questions. The first one is this. Can you cook? Goodness gracious me, what a bore. Off with you. Quite clearly, you wouldn't have done at all, shoo.
I'll give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us wouldn't kill our own. They're picking us off one by one.
Can we just skip to the part where I reassure you and you shut up?
You look me mad.
Mad? No. Insufferable, surely.
What are you trying to hear anyway?
I've seen more appetizing things coming out of plague-stricken pigs.
There's nothing else I can make, Your Majesty. Turnips and water are all I was given.
Here to register, sir. Good, good. You faring okay so far?
I've done anything less than a dozen horse dinner, and I don't intend to do away with the custom.
There has been...
Glad to hear it. You head on in now.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fetch Magister Siwan. We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
Ask what you must.
By all means, do as the officer says, but you had better hurry, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, men, quickly! If she casts source, the Voidwoken will come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
My mask! She stole it. If these savages see me without it, they will have my skull for a goblet.
God damn it! We need to get off this wreck. Quick. Before this thing snaps into splinters. Yes, morph. I need to get off this ship.
No!
That means there's still a chance.
Shut your trap, kid! Children and dwarfs.
The dwarf yanks at one of the nearby ropes.
But there were other people down there.
You see those tentacles, kid? It's time for getting the hell out of here.
Thank you, thank you, thank you! There's a ladder right over there. You can go...
You're gonna be the death of us, you hear? Had to open your big mouth, didn't you?
The Magister lies on the floor, unconscious and bleeding.
If you can walk, get yourself up the ladder. There's a... Wait. Voidwoken.
Beardless bugs won't sink the ship on my watch.
I thought Voidwoken was supposed to be scary.
Let the games begin.
I've faced worse. I have yielded to none.
Telling where there might be more. We need to move.
It's not Tarry. This old tub is about to burst.
I hear something. Sounds like she needs help.
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
That was decidedly unpleasant.
Am I the lone survivor?
Depending on one's definition of survivor, of course.
Voidwoken. Those are the same beasts that sank our ship. Damn. They made it to shore. The Reaper for me. I thought these bloody collars were supposed to keep those things at bay. Drowned and eaten by a Voidwoken. I wonder in which order.
You spot a strange lizard gazing over the water with a steady, malcontent stare. Yes, you recognize him from the ship. It would seem you're not the only one who survived the tentacles of the deep. The lizard turns about with the graceful ease of a dancer, or a duelist. You lock eyes with his, two smouldering embers that sizzle your very soul.
Yes, I imagine you do. You're made of sterner stuff. Chances are I wouldn't have survived the shipwreck had you not returned to the aid of your fellow passengers down in that dreadful hold. You have my gratitude.
Hand over heart, he salutes you with a bob of the head. More than a nod, though less...
Yes, I'm sure you've all the makings of a hero and all that, but let's not get carried away, shall we? Now then, if there's nothing further... I'm sure I don't mean to sound condescending, but I had thought it quite self-evident I was gazing out over the waves.
He sighs dramatically.
Tell me, what do you see when you cast your glance over this ocean? Touché.
He looks out over the water once more, and so do you. A few tranquil moments.
As for myself, when I consider this vast expanse before us, I see an empire. I see continents dotted with mighty cities. And shimmering along the soft curve of the sea's horizon, I picture the palaces that formed my paradise. Look, of course it's rather specific. Quite obviously, I'm musing over the very actual empire that I lost.
Suddenly, having all the air of being deeply offended, he stares at you with utter incredulity.
Well, don't just stand there gawking like an ape at an abacus. Or do you really mean to tell me you don't know who I am? The very same. I am the Red Prince, the All-Conqueror, the World Tamer, the Spouse of the Sun. Of course you know me.
There's a brief moment's pause, during which his grandiloquent pose deflates ever so slightly.
That said, I suppose I must own up to the fact that I find myself rather in between all-conquering and world-taming opportunities at the moment. The grandeur that is my fate has hit a bit of a snag. But never you worry. For the throne I was destined, and my throne I shall have. Truly. A kind offer indeed. And you've already proven to be trustworthy enough. You came back for the others on that ship, after all. Fine, I accept. On one condition. For reasons I'll not disclose right now, it is imperative that I should meet with a dreamer, one of the mystics of my kind. I've reason to believe one of them may be present on this island. Promise me we'll look for him, and I'll extend you the blessing of my company. Jolly good. Oh, my word. How you do astound me. Come now, did you really think a handful of linen towels can fool me? But don't worry. I have studied the arcane arts for years, including necromancy and demonology. I do not hold the petty prejudices of common folks. In fact, I prefer the exceptional in all things. Your secret is safe with me. So, now that that's settled, first things first. Even if you are as versed in the art of eloquence as I am, that our swords will be doing a lot of the talking from here on out goes without saying. As a born fighter, I prefer the perfection of the blade myself. But I'm well acquainted with the secrets of magic, and yes, even subterfuge. What say you? Very well. Onwards then to victory or death.
The Red Prince nods and gives you a smile that wavers ever so delicately between courtesy and contempt.
Now, as you're aware, you'll be travelling with a prince. Proper forms of address include Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, or if you're feeling particularly frivolous, Milord. As your luck would have it, I seem to be fresh out of luggage, so you won't be required to carry my belongings. Of course, there are other forms of protocol to bear in mind, but I'll see to it you'll pick up the rest as we go. So, without further ado, let us be off!
Ah, hello, small, furry creature. How do you do?
The cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at its eyes clear. The cat's eyes appears confused.
That monster. To kill a defenseless little kitten.
Nicer here than that stinking. I'm sure glad you went back to save the others. Saw one of them.
God will ask you a question. Answer.
Stay back, sorcerer, and stay silent.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape, Atusa. We have.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander.
If you can tell the Godwoken no more, you.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come!
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister, whatever she may ask.
Stay silent, you!
Atusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. Her eyes.
Stop! My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be disappointed in you, Atusa. The fate of our realm hangs in the balance. If you will not help us save it, Dallas.
Yes, Your Holiness.
I believe we're done here.
What a waste. Come, we'll be needed elsewhere.
The Lizard Magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of gore.
She was a lizard, yet a magister. No matter her reasons, her penalty was fair.
Did you see him? You did, right? Those claws. Wonder what's behind the masks, too. Can't be pretty.
That, Magister, that was Bishop Alexander, leader of the Divine Order, and his right hand, Dallas. How do you not know this? Better get to it, then. A Magister will come and find you when they're ready for you. Could be a while, though. We're up to our hoods in sinners these days.
Come on then, Lexi.
Hey, I'm having some trouble.
Bread or brisket, toast the same.
Your griff teaches you to bully others. Pathetic.
You keep his name out of your mouth, you filthy cunt.
Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal, the woman is manipulating a glove like.
And what you after? Come again? You another friend of Niles? I told that Magister freak to get back to his little dungeon in the keep, and I'll tell you.
Now get the hell out of my face!
The woman looks up as you approach, wiping her brow with a grease.
What do you need? By all means. Get an eyeful.
Bread or brisket, toast the same.
Your griff teaches you to bully others. Pathetic.
You keep his name out of your mouth, you filthy cunt, you are.
Have you, cud?
Disgusting, just like all your kind.
Disgusting. Like
who in their right mind would think of a thing like this?
Right.
So, this is Fort Jewelry.
Surely you'll have one.
What a crumbling disaster.
Scram! Mm-hmm. Snake face.
Oh, excuse me.
Don't tell anyone where you got this, eh?
Got it.
Pens out, you. Now.
death that get purged, don't you think? You should be happy for me.
Excuse me, ever so tired.
Frightfully busy at the moment, love. Haven't got any liquor on hand, have you? This fella could use a little comfort. All the worse for old Dane. He crossed one of Griff's card sharks and got a club to the skull.
Is that thing eating corpses?
The creature heaves through lips gummed with human gore.
You. Quite lost. Now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? Now, or didn't you hear me? Where grows the yarrow? Dire, and for you too, if you want to keep your top screwed on and your wires in a row. Do you hear me? Where does the yarrow grow? Where?
Yeah.